Hello guys, happy new year, welcome to 2024. And last time I shared to you the 7 things that I've learned in 2023, but for this time I want to share to you 7 things that I am practicing and I am putting in my mind as my mindset and my principle on how I want to overcome my 2024. But before that, tanongin ko muna kayo, ano ang inyong New Year's resolution? Please comment down below if meron kayong New Year's resolution. At kung wala man, okay lang. Okay lang yun. Kanyang naman tayong trip eh. However, no, ano nga ba talaga ang New Year's resolution? Or tinatawag nating resolution? Panoorin natin to.
Everybody wants to the
So a resolution is a firm decision to do or not to do something. Or in short, resolve. Kung nanonood ka ng anime, mas mabilis mong maintindihan. So ganun ang resolution. Ano nga ba ang iyong resolution this 2024? Or anong gusto mong ma-achieve at ayaw mong gawin na ngayong 2024? And here are 7 mindsets or 7 principles that I want to share to you that can help you to maintain your focus to achieve your goals or resolutions this 2024. Number 1, what you are and what you have at the moment is what you have decided. But again, ano man ang meron ka ngayon, yan yung napagdesisyonan mo kahapon, nakaraang linggo, nakaraang buwan, o nakaraang taon. And I want you to take responsibility or accountability to it. Learn to be accountable for your life and your choices. Never blame others. It was your choice. And if you want to keep the choice, then keep it. But if you don't want to keep the choice, change it. You have the power to change it. Number 2, do not compete with others. Compete only with yourself. Ibig sabihin, kung ano yung hindi mo nagawa kahapon, gawin mo na ngayon. Kung ano yung pagkukulang mo kahapon, gawin mo na rin ngayon. At kung ano yung achievement mo kahapon, mas galingan mo pa ngayon. Never compare yourself with others. Bakit? Kasi baka yung level 50 nila ay level 10 mo pala. In short, kung nakita mo yun, mag-discourage ka. But it takes time. It takes a process. Every change that we're trying to adapt, it will take a process. And by due time, maabot mo rin yung level 50 mo. And once you start comparing yourself to others, you are losing your value. Again, iba-iba tayo ng journey. Iba-iba tayo ng proseso. So never compete with others and do not compare yourself to others. Number 3, procrastination is your enemy.
Bangon na.
Okay, so procrastination is your enemy. Kaya nasa isa tayo sa manyahan na habit or tinatawag natin na mamayana. At every time we say mamayana, insecurities will come in. Pag di mo nagawa yung gusto mong gawin or dapat mong gawin, that's the time you feel to start to be insecure with yourself dahil di mo nga siya nagawa. Kaya nga, don't sleep as a loser. In short, before you sleep, try to achieve something productive. You can read a book, you can meditate, you can pray, you can check someone else, kumustahin mo sila, you can help someone else, tulungan mo sila, maybe they're going through something, just be productive. At total, mahilig ka naman magpuyat, yung pagpupuyat mo, imbis na gawitin mo sa panunood ng kung ano-ano pa, gumawa ka na lang ng something productive that you are learning something to give value to yourself. Oh, tama na yan ha, huwag ka na mag-procrastinate, gawin mo na ngayon. Do it now. Number 4, avoid negative energy. Avoid negative energy. Don't focus your energy on negativity. Alam naman natin kung ano ang epekto nito sa'yo. Instead, focus your heart, your mind, and your life on solutions, positivity, and inspiration. Because whatever we input in our hearts and in our minds, it will come out of life. At magkakaroon ito ng epekto sa ating paligid. Kaya nga, focus on gaining value and sharing value to others. Instead na puro negativity ang sinishare natin at puro chismis na lamang, huwag na, tama na yun. Share positivity, share good energy, share positive vibes, share inspiration, share hope to others. Because more people needs you than you ever imagined. And syempre, go with the people who has the same vibe or same energy as you are or you want to be. Tawag natin doon law of attraction. If you wanna be a millionaire or yumaman, sumama ka sa mayaman. No? If you wanna be a good person, sumama ka rin sa mababait na tao. And if you wanna be a helping person, a generous person, or anuman gusto mong maging, sumama ka sa mga klase ng tao. Because you are trying to be infected kung anong meron sila. And that's the best way of you to gain the energy that you desire. But don't let your focus be on negativity. Kaya stay positive and stay inspired. Number 5, do not dwell on the past. Alam na natin to, lagi natin narinig to. And I just wanna remind you that your past does not define you, but your future will. So what you are doing right now will affect your future. Your past is already done. Tapos na yun. Pero anuman ang gusto mong gawin ngayon at umpisahan ngayon at gustong baguhin ngayon, that will determine your future. Use your past as a rearview mirror. Don't stay there. But move on. Move forward. Parang sa magdadrive lang yun eh. Every time na magdadrive tayo or kung nagdadrive ka man, bago ka mag-overtake, titignan mo na yung rearview mirror mo, titignan mo muna yung side mirrors mo para makita mo kung meron bang sasakyan sa likod na oncoming traffic or hindi. And pag wala, you can overtake. So use your past as your rearview mirror to overtake this life. Number 6, be grateful. Of course, number 1, be grateful to God. Bakit? Kasi nakakapanood ka pa nito. Namihinga ka pa, gising ka pa, buhay ka pa. Tama? Be grateful to God. Pangalawa, be grateful to others. To people, to those people who are still there with you through your ups and downs, hills and valleys, they never give up on you. Be thankful to them. Reward yourself every time your goal is achieved. Huwag mong kalimutan i-rewardan yung sarili mo. However, huwag puro reward sa sarili ah. Okay? Baka maubos din eh. But, be grateful. Number 7, be patient on your success. Again, it takes time. It takes time to achieve all the goals and dreams that you want to have. However, success is not gained overnight. Walang ganon. It always takes a process. And if we don't go with the process, mas mahirapan tayong i-receive yung success in the future. Kaya nga, success easy gain is success easy lose at the same time. Kung mabilis mo siya nakuha, maaaring mabilis mo siya mawala. Kaya kailangan may magandang proseso at matibay na proseso tayo pagdadaanan to gain the success that we desire. And especially, be patient on that process. Success is not given, it is earned. Pinaghihirapan ang success. Kaya anuman ang pinagdadaanan mo ngayon o nanghihina ka, it's okay. It's part of it, but always be patient on yourself and jump back on the game of your what you are trying to achieve. Sabi nga nila, it is not the destination, but the journey. The question is, every time that you're trying to achieve your goal, ano ba ang natututunan mo? Every time you fall down, what you learn? Every time you jump back, what you are learning? Every time you are in the process, what are you learning? Always think about those things. Don't just focus on your goals, but focus on the process. Kaya nga, be patient on yourself. So those are the 7 principles and 7 mindsets that I've shared you. And kung may gusto pa kayo dagdag, please comment down. At sa mga susunod na buwan, in 7 months, I wanna share all these things to you to deep dive sa mga bagay na ito. So that I may share value and encouragement and hopes about isa. Once again, I'm not trying to be someone else, but I'm just trying to be here to remind you that you have the potential to overtake what you desire in this life. It's just a matter of you, when and how and why. So again, this is your guy, Rick. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.